Ladies and gentlemen, once again, welcome back to our channel. And the topic for today's COBOL tutorial is COBOL Perform Statement. And in this session, we will primarily focus on what are the different kinds of perform statements and how you can use these perform statements in your COBOL program. So without wasting any time, let's focus on today's agenda. So we start today's session with introduction to COBOL Perform Statement. After that, I will talk about inline and outline COBOL perform statement. Then we will deep dive into different variants of COBOL perform statement. And finally, I will end this session by telling you how to use COBOL perform statements in COBOL program with the help of an example. So ladies and gentlemen, before I start with today's presentation, I would request you all to do subscribe to our channel because we need your support to grow our channel. And in case if you have already subscribed to our channel, then I would like to say a big thank you for your subscription. So let's get started. COBOL programs are generally made up of three logical structure. First one is sequence, second one is selection, and third one is iteration. A sequence structure basically includes one or more functions that are executed in a specific sequence. For example, you have a couple of paragraphs that needs to be executed one by one. So you can use perform statement to execute that piece of logic which is there in different set of paragraphs. Then you have selection. So the selection structure provides a choice between two functions based on a condition. And for that, you need COBOL if-else statement or probably COBOL evaluate statement. And finally, you have iteration structure that execute a function or a piece of logic continuously as long as condition is satisfied. For example, you can use perform until statement to execute a piece of logic continuously until the condition is satisfied. Now let's move on to the next section where we'll look at the definition of COBOL perform statement and the different categories of the perform statement. In layman term, COBOL perform statement is used to transfer control explicitly or implicitly within the paragraph, section, or in the procedure. The perform statement in COBOL is divided into two different categories. First one is inline perform statement, and the second one is outline perform statement. And the major difference between inline and outline perform statement is that inline perform statement mainly execute the piece of logic or set of statement between the perform and end perform statement. And the example of inline perform is perform until statement. However, the outline perform statement is mainly used to perform a set of statement or a piece of logic which is included in a separate paragraph or a section. And the example for outline perform statement is a normal perform statement where you just use perform keyword followed by a paragraph name or a section name. Now, let's look at the different variants of perform statement in COBOL. So there are four different formats of COBOL perform statement, and you can use either of the format in your COBOL program as per your requirement. So the first variant is perform followed by a paragraph name. The second format is perform with times phrase, and the third format is perform with until phrase, and the last format is perform with varying phrase. Now let's focus on a couple of examples associated with each of the format so that you can understand how exactly you can use these perform statements in your COBOL program. So the first example is related to basic perform statement where you have perform keyword followed by a paragraph name. So in this case, I've used two perform statement. First perform statement is executing a paragraph that is A000-calc-tax. So whatever set of statements is there in that paragraph that will be executed. Similarly, in case if you have a section, then you can use perform followed by the first paragraph of that particular section. Then you have through followed by the last paragraph of that particular section. So this is how you can execute the sequence of paragraph within that particular section. Second example is associated with perform with times phrase. So in this example, you have a perform statement followed by a paragraph name, and then you have the number of times you want to execute that particular paragraph. So in this example, I would be executing a-000-calc-text 3 times. Similarly, if you want to execute a set of paragraphs within that particular section, so you can use perform followed by a paragraph name, then through followed by a paragraph name, and then number of times you want to execute that particular piece of logic. Third example is associated with perform with until phrase, and in this example you have a perform statement followed by a paragraph name, that is a-000-read until there's a flag that is not end of the file. So the logic which is mentioned in the paragraph will keep on reading data from the file until there is no more record in that file. That means when the flag not end of the file is set. Now the second statement within this particular example is of inline perform, where you specify the logic within perform and end perform. And in this case, what I've done is I've just specified the file read logic in between perform and end perform. So this logic will keep on executing until not end of the file flag is set. Now let's move on to example number 4, and this example is associated with perform with varying phrase. So in this case, I have a perform statement followed by a paragraph name, that is a-000-TBL-INC varying I from 1 by 1 until I is greater than 10. So it will keep on executing that particular logic which is mentioned in the paragraph, and it will keep on increasing the value of I 1 by 1 until the value is greater than 10. Similarly, you can also use with test after or with test before parameters to check the condition before executing a logic or after executing a logic. So ladies and gentlemen, this marks an end to our today's session on COBOL perform statement and how you can use this perform statement in your COBOL program. So in case if you like this video, then please hit like button and do subscribe to our channel, because we need your support to grow our channel. And in case if you have any feedback for us, then please do mention that in the comment section. I'm going to respond back after this presentation. Thank you so much and take care.